Good morning, everybody. I wish my lectures were this well attended. So, welcome to the grand opening program for our smart manufacturing laboratories. We have been planning on this for 4 or 5 years. So we are delighted to have this day and to have you here. Absolutely delighted. Purdue University is Indiana's land-grant university with a mission to support the state, the region, and now the world. These labs dedicated today represent our commitment to manufacturing, one of the great wealth-creating backbones of the Indiana economy. We have a lot of named laboratories and spaces in this building. General support for the facilities made possible by the generosity of many people and organizations. Many of those folks are here today. I'd like all of our corporate donors, partners, to stand up and be recognized. Unfortunately, probably most of you already are standing. Truly stunning, isn't it? The amount of support that we've received to make this happen. So I'm Ken Burbank. I'm the head for the School of Engineering Technology, which is one of 6 academic units in the Purdue Polytechnic. Engineering technology has been an integral part of Purdue for more than 60 years, and we are honored to represent the T in STEM education. Our 4 undergraduate degree programs have deep ties to the interdisciplinary nature of advanced manufacturing, and most of our graduates become engineers working in industry. The dedication event today is in recognition of our newest program, Smart Manufacturing Industrial Informatics, and the 4 new labs being dedicated are here to support our emphasis on experiential education. Both the new program and the new labs were created with industry involvement, again, and many of those company representatives are here today. Our gratefulness for these corporate partners increases our commitment to serve our students and our graduates. We have several speakers here today in this short ceremony. Our first person, John Dyck, is the Chief Executive Officer for SESME, and representing the Smart Manufacturing Institute. SESME is funded by the federal government and serves to advocate for smart manufacturing nationwide. John.
Well, good morning. It's truly an honor to be here. It's truly a privilege to see the level of collaboration to put this incredible institute together. We've been honored to work with Purdue in a very strategic way for a number of years now, supporting you all with financial support, but even more importantly with the broader community here. The sort of future-proof capabilities and insights and the community that represents a collaborative effort to bring manufacturing back to the front of mind for families, for parents, for children, for students, and of course for all of the great workers across this country. We've seen, unfortunately over the last decade, we've seen for the first time in recorded history a decline in the U.S. manufacturing productivity at a particular point in time when it's most important, most urgent that we have productivity growth as we regionalize supply chains and create a more productive environment for the reshoring and friendshoring of manufacturing here in the U.S. And as this kind of effort, we believe, with our friend Raghu, with our friends from Rockwell, from PTC, from Microsoft, from Flexware, and many, many other great organizations, that allows us the privilege of putting this kind of a facility together. We're honored to be part of it. I promise to keep my comments brief, but we just want to express our appreciation as a national institute focused on smart manufacturing for what has happened here and for the privilege of playing a small role in supporting it. Thank you.
Thank you, John. Our next speaker is the Honorable Jun Yanagi, who is the Consul General of Japan in Chicago and is here representing Japan in 10 states in the Midwest. We are glad that he's here to gain an understanding of what Purdue has to offer and to hear his insights on future partnerships.
Thank you for your kind introduction. Good morning, everyone. My name is Jun Yanagi. I have been serving as Consul General of Japan to Midwest 10 states, including, first and foremost, this great state of Indiana. Last night, I joined some series of events in Indianapolis, one which is a kind of roundtable of Japanese manufacturing companies based here in Indiana. Many of them expressed that they have started facing some workforce development challenges which digital and other new technologies across entire manufacturing sector have been posing. So I am excited to experience how to address these workforce development challenges in a smarter manner. Also, I am grateful to the collaborations and partnership of Japanese universities and companies with Purdue in general and with Smart Learning Factory and Smart Manufacturing Labs in particular. Let me share with a few examples. First, this March, your Purdue President Man Chen visited Japan, where he announced a fellowship named after Nobel Prize winner, Japanese professor in Purdue, Nedishi-san, to expand student exchanges as well as research and development cooperation with Japan. Actually, I have just learned that Professor Nedish hosted dozens of high school students from Japan here in Purdue a couple years ago from high school where he graduated from many, many years ago. And incidentally, I have just learned I graduated from the same high school in Kanagawa Prefecture. And now, no longer Nedish-san has passed away, unfortunately, a couple years ago. The high school asked me to host dozens of students in Chicago this year. So I will do that. And I learned how enthusiastically Professor Nedish hosted these students. I have to follow suit. And second, President Man Chen visited Japan again this May to establish upward network for Japan-U.S. workforce advancement and R&D in semiconductors. And third, here in Smart Learning Factory, a software is provided by Flexware Innovation, which is now under Japanese company Hitachi. And finally, some of you may drive Subaru, including my friends from Jersey. These are produced in Lafayette here. So within Subaru factory, workers now can take part in lectures and earn degrees of Purdue Polytechnic Institute while staying in the factories in Lafayette. So these are just a couple of educational and business partnership between Japan and Purdue. I hope that today's grand opening, Japan will act as a catalyst for all of you here to learn more about Japan-U.S. connection. Once again, my sincere congratulations on the grand opening, and I look forward to experiencing Smart Manufacturing Labs in person and seeing the further academic industry collaboration between Japan and Midwest. Thank you so much indeed.
Thank you very much, Consul General. Our next speaker is our Dean, Daniel Castro, who's providing the leadership to ensure that manufacturing in our college is both multidisciplinary and relevant to our stakeholders.
So good morning, everyone. My name is Daniel Castro. I'm the Dean of the Purdue Polytechnic, and it's an honor for me to be here at this special moment for the School of Engineering Technology and for the Polytechnic Institute. As you can see, we live in a world where technology changes rapidly. The manufacturing industry needs people who are skilled and can adapt to these changes. At Purdue Polytechnic, we're not just keeping pace with these changes. we are leading the charge. We have all heard the statistics that were mentioned before. By 2030, 2.1 million manufacturing jobs may remain unfilled, threatening the core of our industry. This skills gap is clear. It's a clear call for action, and Purdue has answered the call. Over the past 5 years, our focus has been on addressing the workforce development challenges in manufacturing and engineering. Our response to this challenge is significant. We have established the first and largest smart learning factory in the US, supported by a comprehensive and innovative curriculum. This is not just a temporary fix. It marks a substantial step forward in manufacturing education. Our new Smart Manufacturing and Industrial Informatics program is designed to ensure that our students are not just learners, but innovators and leaders in the field. With facilities like our Smart Manufacturing ecosystem, we are immersing our students in an environment that mirrors the real-world challenges and opportunities they will face in the industry. This applied approach, combined with our focus on advanced technologies like AI, robotics, cloud computing, and automation, ensures that our graduates are not just industry ready day one, but are equipped to lead the industry into the future. But none of this would have been possible without the incredible support and collaboration of our corporate partners. Your belief in our vision and your investment in our mission have been crucial in making this project a reality. I would like to take a moment to acknowledge and thank all of you. So as we stand here today, ready to showcase what we have built, we do so with the confidence that Purdue Polytechnic is not just educating the next generation. We are shaping the future of the manufacturing industry, ensuring it remains dynamic, innovative, and most importantly, capable of meeting the challenges of tomorrow. Thank you, and I invite you to join us in exploring these state-of-the-art facilities and seeing firsthand the future of manufacturing education. Thank you.
So it's a pleasure for me to introduce President Meng's Chief of Staff and also the Vice President, the Executive Vice President for industry relationship. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thanks everybody for being here this morning. It's so, I'm delighted to be here with you, and we appreciate you taking time out of your day to be with us to celebrate. Maybe just a few remarks, and one being that I think that this is the best example of a trifecta partnership. And that is when Purdue University engages with industry. And thank you to all of our corporate partners for your generosity in making today possible. And then also working with our local and global governments, including SESME and others. We appreciate that very much. And working with other universities and nonprofits. So I would just like to take this opportunity to thank everyone here and for helping to have this become a reality. The second thing is that congratulations to Consul-General Yanagi, and we look forward to working with you in your new role. I don't know if many of you know, but Purdue University has been working with Japan for many decades. We signed our first MOU in partnership with a Japanese university back when Dr. Stephen Beering was our president back in the 90s. We're very proud of our relationship with Japan, and there are over 300 Japanese companies here in the state of Indiana, and so we're very grateful for that. And then maybe lastly, what I'd like to do is to thank the Dauch family. They're not here today, but it is the Dauch family that has named these laboratories. And in fact, this whole facility is named after the Lambertus family and the Dudley family. And without their philanthropy, none of this would be possible. The fact that we're all here today, the fact that the School of Engineering Technology is located in this facility, these families are not with us, but they've been very, very generous to Purdue over the years. And it's our with a heartfelt thanks that we appreciate them for their involvement. So maybe I'll end with another thanks, and we're going to now, I guess, unveil the new facility, but hail Purdue, and thank you very much.